Being thankful is a choice. Today, choose to enjoy the good that each day brings. It can be done. If you're in debt, be thankful you're not the person that you owe the money to. Life will always have problems. Worry prevents you and I from seeing the world around us and its beauty. So today, choose to be grateful and see your cup half full, not almost empty. This reminds me of a great story. It's called Wishing You a Cup of Coffee. A group of alumni, highly established in their careers, got together to visit their old university professor. Conversations soon turned into complaints about stress in work and life. Offering his guests coffee, the professor went to the kitchen and returned with a large pot of coffee and an assortment of cups, porcelain, plastic, glass, crystal, some plain-looking, some very expensive, and some were just exquisite, telling them to help themselves to the coffee. When all the students had a cup of coffee in hand, the professor said, "If you noticed, all the nice-looking, expensive cups were taken up, leaving behind the plain ones, the less expensive ones, and the very cheap ones. While it is normal for you to want only the best for yourselves, that is the source of your problems and stress. The cup itself adds no quality to the coffee. In most cases, it is just more expensive, and in some cases even hides what we drink. What all of you really wanted was coffee, not the cup. But you consciously went for the best cups. And then you began eyeing each other's cups. Now consider this. Life is the coffee. The jobs, money, and position in society are the cups. They are just tools to hold and contain life. And the type of cup we have does not define or change the quality of life we live. Sometimes, by concentrating only on the cup, we fail to enjoy the coffee God provides for us. God brews the coffee, not the cup. Enjoy your coffee. The happiest people don't have the best of everything. They just make the best of everything. Learn to live simply. Love generously. Care deeply. Speak kindly. And leave the rest to God. We are all living on borrowed time, and I thank God for being the lender. In closing, I want us to concentrate on gratitude and think about all the things that we can be grateful for. We can be grateful that in each of our lives there is enough rain so that we can appreciate the sun, and enough happiness to keep our spirits alive, enough pain so that even the smallest of joys in life may appear to be bigger. Enough gain to satisfy our wanting, and enough loss to appreciate all that we possess. Let us be thankful for enough sun to keep our attitudes bright no matter how gray the day may appear. Let us be thankful for the hellos we get each day. They will help us get through the final goodbye. This is Lynda Lewis, reminding you that actions do speak louder than words, and doing is far more important than saying. Sometimes, after all is said and done, more is said than done. Today, make it a point to be thankful for those special people that God has put into your life. Remember, you can meet a person in a moment, and you can appreciate a person in an hour. You can learn to love them in a day, but sometimes it takes your entire life to forget someone.